Tim Horton's Premium Blend Coffee bring you the starting goaltenders tonight. Nathan Lawson, he's a rookie. Well, so is the backup goaltender, Kevin Poulin. And it'll be Lawson who will get the nod tonight for the New York Islanders to start and making his 24th consecutive start in goal. Ryan Miller for the Buffalo Sabres, fresh off the victory in Boston last night. Buffalo Sabres presented in high definition by Stereo Advantage. Stereo Advantage, your source for HD TV. The officials, Gord Dwyer, Mike Lego, they're the referees. As Lego drops the puck, Steve Barton and Greg Dvorsky, the linesman. McDonald fired it through the middle. That's broken up by Leopold. Long pass ahead. Didn't get to Commonville, and it's scooped out to center for Konopka. Konopka bringing along the boards. He gets whacked by Hesch and lost his stick. But around behind the net and getting out of the way was Matador. Now to center for Leopold. Knocked off his stick. Martin couldn't get anywhere. Vanek stealing it back but couldn't carry on any farther. And it'll be tipped high in the air inside the Buffalo line where Matador gets it back again. Matador up on the wing rings one in. Coletta charging in back. Kept in there, now knocked down, and Tavares starts away. Tavares, who had the hat trick against Buffalo in the last game between the two teams, cleared it in front of the net, but it's taken back again, and the Sabres start right back with Coletta's pass to center to Gostad. He brought it in over the line. Sequeira got in a little early.
Phillip will get a power play in 50 seconds. Nothing else happens with reference.
7 minutes into this opening period. Islanders come up with it off the faceoff through center ice in over the Buffalo line with a shot. Miller making the save on Grabner. Spun back in the corner, intercepted, and then Myers recovered to knock it away. And it came in front and scores off Tyler Myers' skate into the net, and the Islanders take the lead.
The sad thing in there is Tyler Myers realized that puck was in his feet, and he almost looked like he tried kicking it up to get it to his stick here, and it's kicked it right into the net. It's unfortunate. You're gonna see the puck come right out to the front, and he realized it. He tried directing it and kicking it up to the stick. It bounced straight off in between.
It all started with a giveaway. And the Sabres never got the puck back, and that was more of a pass than a shot, but you know where it ended up, and you don't know what the score is.
And that comes with each team playing a man short. Ragnani now steering it around behind the net. Midway through this opening period.
9-3 the shots in favor of the Islanders.
Back to the point. They score! The shot from the point taken by McDonald finds its way into the net, and the Islanders have a 2-0 lead.
That's McDonald's first goal of the season. He leads the team in ice time. And I don't think that was deflected by anybody. And I think we might be going to see a goaltender change. In fact, I know we are. As Patrick Lalime gets ready on the bench to come in.
Yeah, it looked like it was redirected by the man in front. Lindy Ruff's kind of giving it to his players right now on the last, about waking up and getting ready to play. He's going, we weren't ready, we're not ready, and he's trying to push them here to get them going a little bit.
Ryan Miller walks down the aisleway behind the bench, trying to blow off some steam. He's not going to go to the dressing room, but he's upset, and he should be. And the whole team should be.
Oh, take a look. That goes right off his skate in front.
So two goals have gone in off skates instead of sticks.
Just around behind the net. Dropped it off to Kirby. Kirby takes his shot. Lawson to save the rebound. And he covers up and hangs on. Oh, it's 7-0.
Well, neither goaltender in the lineup for the Islanders have ever played a game against Buffalo, so you know that Jim Corsi must have gone to the coaching staff in Portland to get a bit of a scouting report on these two guys. Well, who have played a good chunk of the year in Bridgeport.
Right, but there is video available. They have played in the NHL, so. Sequeira slips it over for Ennis. Ennis back to Myers. Grabner steers it up. Now it's belted in by Sakara. He'll be whacked at it. Came all the way back to Myers, who holds it in there. Left in behind the net. Islanders come up with the puck. Don't get it out. Hess keeping it in. Hess cleared it in to Ennis. Went around behind the net. Ennis out in front. The shot by Myers. He flicked wide. They jam at it. Went around behind the net. Play is called as the net gets knocked off, but the goaltender is down.
Jochen Hess just shaking his head as he hurts. Terrific opportunity.
They're calling for the trainer. But he's getting to his feet himself.
Well, the New York Islanders have suffered a ton of injuries to key players. DiPietro's not here. He's got the flu. He played last night but didn't feel good enough to make the trip. And Buffalo nearly cuts it to a one-goal advantage as Jochen Hess can't get the puck back to his forehand. And the goaltender Lawson's left leg was in the way, as his glove was.
And Lawson says he's going to stay in there. 3 minutes to go here in this opening period. Buffalo still with the man advantage.
Well, first period highlights, you need the rubber gloves out. These are yuck.
Yeah, sure. Turnover there by Myers, and he ends up kicking into the net. Buffalo looks like scrambled eggs in their own zone. You can see the puck hits them right in the left foot. Not done there. Face-off fans, they lose the face-off cleanly. One pass, second pass, in it goes. 2-0 Islanders.
We know this. They can do better in the second period, and for that, we're going to hand it back off to Rick Jenneret, Harry Neal, and Rob Ray here on MSG.
Ryan Miller started for Buffalo. Patrick Lalime's in goal. Nathan Lawson started for the Islanders. Kevin Poulin's in goal.
And Nathan Lawson is not on the Islander bench.
He did take a tumble to the ice late in the period, as we mentioned. He carried on and continued the period, but is unable to go any farther. Got it ahead to center. Brought back in over the line and tapped in around behind the net. Poulin chasing after it. Lost it. Out in front. Oh, and Vanek drilled it right into the defenseman, Martina. Hess trying to knock it free in the corner.
Came out of the net, fumbled the puck, fell, and Martina, the defenseman, blocked the shot by Vanek when there was no goaltender in the net. A little bad luck on that one. It's always a big joke when they don't score. I see Martinik smiling on the bench.
Oh, yeah. Only 3 minutes into the second period.
Well, Lawson played the first period and on a good scoring chance by Hest. It looks like he might have hurt himself on this play. He makes the save, but he had trouble getting up as if it was a hamstring or a muscle pull in his left leg. And the trainer came running out, but Lawson talked the trainer into letting him finish the period, but not the game by the look of it.
Out there for Shrimp. Shrimp gave it away. Niedermeyer in over the line. McCormick's blast right on the rebound. Tip just wide of the net. And the Islanders get an opportunity to bring it out. And
the Sabres look like they got a little more energy this period so far. They've had a couple of chances to score. Niedermeyer goes to the net in a hurry, and the rebound's available, but he cannot get his stick on it before the goaltender, Poulin, knocks it into the corner.
Yeah, Harry, they have come out with a little more energy.
This is his third real good game in a row. Played well against Montreal, and then last night in Boston, right in front of the net, and Poulin covered up again. The puck squirted free, but the whistle had already gone as Gordy Dwyer, the referee, lost sight of it.
Yeah, that puck was laying out. I don't think the goaltender had it covered, and because the referee was below the goal line, not able to see, it's live there. It's live on the far side of his glove, and he lost sight of it, so he blew the whistle.
Well, it's a tough call because it certainly looked when that first replay that he did have his glove on him, but he.
Now the pass coming across ice is brought back in over the line with Commonville. Hooked it in front. Wadidor fires it. And it's cleared up beside the net again. Poulin flopped down. The puck went behind him. And in behind the net, play has been called. And they're ruling the faceoff is coming out of the zone, a glove pass.
Yeah.
Weber rips it around on the boards to Vanek. Bannock's pass across ice. Sakara had to wait for it, and Tavares takes it away. Tom Moulson. He'll stuff it in down low. Weber going after it in the corner. And coming up with the puck. On to, now it's cleared in front and stolen away. The shot, they score! All alone was Parenteau, and he buries it, and it's 3-0 Islanders.
Real nice heads-up play for Tavares, realizing he had a man wide open in front after picking off that play along the wall.
Well, the Sabres looked like they were coming out along the left wing, and every Sabre was either outside the blue line or over on the left boards, and the backhand pass to Parenteau, and he made no mistake to make it 3-0, his 12th goal of the season.
Well, two mistakes there, Harry. That forward can't leave the zone and get going so fast. He's got to make sure that play's coming up. And that D, if he realizes he's not there, put it hard enough to get it out of the zone.
Charging after it. Ennis drops it off for Niedermeyer. Niedermeyer getting away from Gervais. Niedermeyer still with the puck. Got it back. Ennis with a shot. That's knocked down. Ennis chases after it once more. Ennis ducks around behind the net. Ennis turns, cleared it in front. There's a chance right beside the net. And Niedermeyer unable to put it in. Well, work down low again. Niedermeyer's got it once more behind the goal. Giving another whack at it. Greer left it for Niedermeyer. Trying to jam it in. Went right beside the goal again. Ennis has got it. Ennis tipping it back. Over it comes Grignani. He takes a screenshot. That went off a leg. Picked up again by Ennis. Ennis fires it over. Here's Grignani walking in. Shoot off the goal post. Grignani's got it again. Grignani in behind the net. Getting it back to the point. Monador spins it off to Greer. Greer sending it to Monador. In deflected, right beside the goal again. Ennis trying to take it away, and he does in the corner. Back it comes down to Morrison. He fed it in front. Greer can't get it, and the Islanders, in desperation, whack it down the ice. And boy, oh boy, if a team ever needed a change, it's the New York Islanders, and they're not going to get a chance.
Well, that's the best offensive zone shift Buffalo's had in this game, let alone this period. And they could have had two or three goals on it.
Islanders are calling a timeout here.
Ennis trying to hold it in. Does. Ennis slipping it across ice. Walking in Morrison with a shot, and Poulin on his knees will hang on to it. Takes it back. Hest will guide it up for Monador. Monador brings it in over the line to Kirby. Kirby took a shot, and Poulin snares it and hangs on to it. 13 and a half to go here in this third period. And Greer couldn't come up with it behind the goal, and it's thrown off the boards, kept in to Kirby. Kirby trying to get free. He drilled a shot right on, and Poulin hangs on to it.
Our McDonald's game reset will take you back to the three goals the New York Islanders have scored. Grabner got the first, his 13th of the year. Moulson got the second, his 15th of the year. And P.A. Parenteau got the third, his 12th of the year. So the...
Right back onto the stick of Leopold. 6 minutes to go on the third. On to Monador. He'll get it across ice. Hesh charging in along the boards. His backhand, and that went wide. Hest tried to get it in front, deflected, and then goes in wide of the net. Hest has it again, getting away. He tried to jam it in the short side, and reaching out after it is Poulin, who lost control of it. And lost his glove. Islanders bring it back with a shot right on. Lalime to save the rebound, they score! Punched into the net by the Islanders on the rebound, and they have taken a 4-0 lead here in the third period.
That may well have been the second slug he had it after the rebound.
Konopka, I believe, is going to get credit for the goal.
There's one shot, two shots, and then
no,
third
Hillen.
Shot.
Hillen.
And he had all kinds of time and didn't have to worry about getting knocked down. A defenseman in on the rush for his second goal of the season.
Yeah, both defensemen stopped in front of the net and instead of taking a man there. You know, you had Leopold and Monador both standing in front of the net while the man was off to the side taking the second and third opportunity.
Well, yeah. Goes into the corner. Kirby battling in along the wall. Came free. Back now to Grignani, and his shot went off a leg. Tipped around on the boards. Kirby battling for it while he's lying on the ice. Got it to Hest. He got checked. Went in behind the net. Around on the boards again. Back to the point. Grignani kept it in, but now it's scooped out to center. And here are the Islanders in over the line. The pass and a shot. It fired wide. As it was taken by Oposo, it came in front again. And blocking it was Grignani. Back to the point. And then the Islanders are fanning on it. Now cleared back into the corner. And slides right beside the net. Hess takes it away. And Hess tried to clear it out. He couldn't get it out. It came in front. The shot, they scored. This time it's finally stuffed in by Grabner with 1.7 seconds left on the clock.
About four different Sabres had the puck but couldn't get it out of the zone. And in a goal that isn't going to make any difference to the outcome of the game, with 1.7 seconds to go, makes it 5-2 Islanders. Not play nearly as well as they have in the past three or four games.
And that will bring it officially to an end as the Islanders skate off the ice with a 5-2 victory here in downtown Buffalo. And being outshot in the process, 38-29, but they couldn't care less. They've got the win at HSBC Arena. And let's go to Kevin with Alexis Shootouts.
All right, thank you, Rick. A 5-2 loss to the New York Islanders last Saturday. It was a 5-3 loss to the New York Islanders.